Never assume that you know everything about someone just because you watch their vlogs. Keep in mind that the judgments you're making are based only on the information that they've chosen to provide about themselves, which may be embellished or merely incomplete. Anything beyond what they've chosen to include is probably a creation of your own mind, and as such, it may be inappropriate to the actual video. Opinions that you form about the person or the events that they talk about in the video might be best kept to yourself. An obvious exception to this is if the person is openly asking for advice.
If you have any sort of offline relationship with the person and you've watched one or more of their videos, you should inform them of this immediately. Think of vlogs as a sort of personal journal in video form, no less sacred than a diary hidden behind a bookcase. Even if they've told you about their vlogs, you should tell them if you continue to watch. For many people, vlogging is an outlet, and if they know that someone that they know offline is watching, it may impede their ability to freely express themselves. So if they ask you not to watch, don't continue to watch.
If someone talks about you in a video and you don't appreciate what they say, contact them, either by phone call, if you know them personally, or in an email, or in YouTube's case, messaging. Be respectful about it, and be mature. Just because they say something that you found offensive doesn't mean they meant it that way. You may also want to explain that you're entitled to your privacy too, but in order to do that, you have to be respectful of theirs. Otherwise, you're being a hypocrite. If they don't stop talking about you, eventually they'll get bored and talk about something else. Ex-friends, lovers, and estranged family members that have been cut out of a person's life should refrain from watching their videos. Because you've been cut out, you really have no need for an update on their life.
People who make vlogs usually appreciate viewer comments. If the person has enabled any form of commenting option, use it. Constructive criticisms are usually acceptable. However, if you do choose to comment, do so respectfully. If you can't write your thoughts out in a friendly tone, it's best that you don't offer your opinion at all. Most people who make vlogs enjoy getting to know about the people who watch their videos. When contacting a person for the first time, be intelligent about it. Check their other videos and their channel page out to see if the answers are already available for any questions you might have. They won't appreciate wasting their time, nor would you in their position. People put time and effort into their vlogs. Take time to find the information they provide you with before asking for more.
Some people who make videos receive a lot of comments and emails. It might take them up to a month before they get a chance to read what you wrote them. Try to be patient. The delay in their replying to you probably has something to do with their schedule and not what you perceive to be some personal vendetta against you. Always be tactful and respectful. If you become overly intrusive, the possibility of you and them becoming friends greatly diminishes. Keep in mind that in a way, you're peering into their life. You, on the other hand, may be a complete stranger to them, and they may or may not want to keep it that way. The choice is entirely up to them. Never attempt to contact somebody in a way they haven't provided. Don't try to find their home phone number, mailing address, or other personal information that they have chosen not to provide for their viewers to use. If the person suddenly stops posting videos, it's all right to ask them why. But if they decline to give you an explanation, then you should respect their privacy.
The internet is a place where free and creative expression may be encouraged. In any environment where people are allowed such freedom, conflict tends to arise. So if an author uses language or materials that offend you on a personal level, stop watching the video. Remember that you viewed the content in their video of your own free will, contacting the person, their ISP, or the website that contains the material to demand that they remove or alter the content is, well, frankly inappropriate and slightly immature. An exception to this is if the content the individual has created somehow violates the rights of another person. If in doubt, it's advisable to seek the opinion or advice of a person whose judgment you respect, even when their view does not match your own. Have them watch the video and discuss it with you before you take more drastic action.